Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alhamdulillah. My name is Habeeb Thabit. I'm sure all of us already know me. Some of y'all are calling me already Pando Shabbat. Alhamdulillah. From the time that the admin posted in our group that we should choose the title on our presentation today, I chose the biography of KZN. Since I am around KZN, and I thought that no, it would be easier for me to get the information on the history or biography of KZN.
Jamiatul Ulama.
Then I mean Jamiatul Ulama of KZN. Then I tried my best. I went a couple of times to the Jamia of KZN to ask for some information regarding how was it started and how did they start the Jamia of KZN. And it was too bad. Believe me, it wasn't easy to get whatever data I got at the moment. Because when the first time I went, they refused me. Because I went and I wasn't wearing kurta. I just was wearing normal and I went, I gave salam and I introduced myself, who I am, where I come from and what I do and what I wanted from them. And so they told me that no, they don't give such kind of information to anyone. So I tried till I got back home. Then after a week I went back again, still the same thing happened. And it was better the first time because the person that I found, I met in the first place, it was a person that he spoke to me nicely, we don't do this. But second person, just subhanAllah, it was too bad. And luckily, alhamdulillah, I got one person's phone number from there. And when I reach home, then I call him at night. So when I called him, so we started talking. My phone got a call recorder. So whatever that I would share with you today is what I recorded. The phone recorded the time that I was speaking to the person. I was asking and he was answering me, inshallah. The short history or biography of Jamia Ulama KZN. The Jamia Ulama of KZN, which is also known as the Council of Muslim Theologians, is involved in various activities in the service of Islam and Muslims in Southern Africa, in South Africa, particularly in the KwaZulu-Natal region. The short history or biography of this organization is that the Jamia of KZN was established on the 15th of January, which was 1955, and Islamic date was 20th of Jamadul Ula, 1374, at the East Madrasa in Pietermaritzburg, which is in Durban. The goal of its establishment was to protect and to propagate the true religion of Islam. This body, the Jamia Ulama of KZN, was to become a fortress of Islam, holding aloft the banners of truth. It was indeed the momentous occasion when the founder members of this body met to establish this organization, which was to become the controlling body of religious, educational, and other affairs of the Muslim community of KwaZulu-Natal. And among the founder members of this organization were one of them is the great Sheikh, who is mentioned earlier, the former principal of Darul Uloom Newcastle, Maulana Qasim Muhammad Sema Rahmahullah, also Maulana Abdul Rahman Ansar, Maulana Muhammad Hanif, Maulana Ahmad Desai, Maulana Ahmad Sabat, Maulana Sayyid Muhammad Lut, Maulana Ahmad Umarji, and many other more ulamas. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them barakah and khair, inshallah. The first premises occupied by the Jamia Ulama of KZN on a part-time basis was in a small room in the famous madrasa, in a famous madrasa arcade. And after a few years later, an office was opened at a place called Siani Center in Queen Street in Durban. And after a while, a full-time office was opened in Pine Street in the Anjuman Islamic Building. in Durban. In the year 1994, the Jamia purchased its own building and put its office there. Among the first important tasks by the Jamia was to establish proper madaris for the imparting of religious education. And Maulana Abdul Rahman Ansari did personally take the initiative to fulfill this task of opening the madaris. The fight against the apartheid government in South Africa had only begun when the Jamia delegations made representation on a number of issues, affecting the Muslim in general. For example, like the fact that the masajid cannot be demolished. And also the Jamia Ulama of KZN, they are involved in different activities. And some of the activities are issuance of fatwas and answering questions regarding to masail of deen, settlements of marital disputes, supervising the madaris, publications of Islamic literatures, social welfarers, certification of halal food, allocation of scholarships and bursaries. And they also do marriage counseling, which is handled by the marriage officers from the Jamia, who attend the marital disputes, marriage breakdowns, abuse, and social domestic problems. Every effort is first made to bring about some form of reconciliation between among people. So, Jamia Ulama KZN, they are involved in a lot of activities. Some of them we cannot mention in this moment because of the time. And that's all. It's only a short thing that I managed to grab from this brother, inshallah, that from Jamia Ulama of KZN, inshallah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make things easy for them, for the work of deen that they are doing. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for each and every one of us, inshallah.